Good morning, children.
Welcome to the online class.
In this class, we will discuss about production and employment. What is a production?
Transformation of raw materials into goods and services.
That we call as a production. And employment. This production process gives some employment to the people. Okay, now, in this, suppose we have to learn about the GDP. What is GDP? Gross domestic product. How to calculate it and what is GDP? GDP means the total value of all the final goods and services produced in the country. That means the value of all the final goods and services produced in the country comes under GDP. All the services, all the manufactured goods values and also the value of all the services will be calculated and will be added, and that will be named as a GDP. But some services we won't add it. That services of a housewife, services of a woman which she will do for a house, it won't be added. Okay, that the remaining all the things, all the services also will be added to the GDP. In this, changes in the importance of sectors. The GDP adds the value of all the goods and services which are done in all the sectors. What are the sectors? Primary sector, secondary sector and tertiary sector. That only we call it as a service sector. Which means the works done by us, done by the people based upon the work schedule, we named it as a different names of the sectors. They are the land and farming, agriculture, the allied works comes under agriculture sector. Manufacturing of goods, that comes under industrial sector. Where we won't produce any goods, just they provide services, that comes under service sector. So now we will see the changes in the importance of sector. Importance of the sectors means many of the developed countries had agriculture and their allied products as the good contributor for the GDP, and not only GDP, for agriculture, for employment also, that only. That means agriculture provided a good amount in GDP as well as in employment also. When the methods of farming were introduced, new methods of agriculture are introduced, that time agriculture also started abundantly. The production of agriculture also increased. They produced more and more even before what they did. By that the things which are made from the agriculture or farming, that also increased. Automatically, employment also increased there, and it contributed a good number in GDP. Whereas, when they by the new techniques, factories are established. They started producing goods, manufacturing goods, and the people, those who worked in the farms, they started to work in the factories. So the industrial sector improved. The contribution to the GDP from the industrial sector also improved, and employment also increased there. After that, slowly, to get a work for the development of agriculture and industrial sector, the service sector also became a dominant sector. Because for the development of industries and agriculture, services needed. So the employment also increased, and the contribution for the GDP also increased. What comes under service sector? Related to the community, finance, banking, travel, insurance. students, all this comes under service sector only. Now we will see employment. What is the share of this sectors in the employment? Now we will see. Now, employment and distribution of workers in India. Now the sectors are providing employment. Now, so what percentage they are providing? We will see here. GDP will increase. The population increases, na, then automatically GDP also increases because the production should be increased. When the population increases, the government has to provide employment opportunities to the people. Then only GDP, they will buy something, and then as per the demand, the supply also increases. Simultaneously, GDP also will increase. Here, as for the 2009 to 2010, our population is nearly 120 crores. Whereas out of that 120 crores, 46 crore people are workers. That means all the sectors, all the 46 crore people related to the three sectors. How much percentage they are working in each sector? We will see in this table. First, in our agriculture sector, whereas in the rural area 68% and in industrial sector 17% and service sector 15%. Which sector is leading up in rural areas? Agriculture. And in urban areas, agriculture only 8% of the people are working. In industrial sector 24% of the people are working, whereas in service sector 58% of the people are working. In which sector the people, the urban people are working? Service sector. Okay, next, sex, male and female. Nowadays female also working, na? So we will see in the agriculture how much percentage of the people are employed. Male people 47, whereas in the industry 34, and in service 90. 19% of the people only working. But if we observe, the female employment in agriculture is 69%. That means most of the women in rural areas working in agriculture only. Most of the female workers, if you want to see, we can see observe in agriculture sector only. Whereas in industry 16% and industry service sector 15 only. Overall, 53% of the workers are working and employed in employment there in agriculture sector, and 22% in the industrial sector, and 25% in the service sector. But might be it is previously it is 80%, but by 2009 to 2010 it came to 53%. Now we will see the distribution. Now we will see employment in different sectors. Here we have two pie charts. One is sectoral shares of employment and shares of three sectors in GDP. That means that this pie charts will give you information about the share in employment. That means in which sector, how much percentage of the people are working. And in this pie chart, you will get what is the contribution of each sector in GDP. You will get that information. Okay, here, they compare with the gap of more than 25 years. That means 70 to 73 and with the 2009 to 2010, they gave information to us. Whereas in 1972 to 73, nearly 74% of the employment was there in agriculture. Whereas, I am comparing the GDP also, contribution to the GDP also. Whereas, in employment is 74%, but in GDP the share is 43%. That means employment is 74 and GDP share is 43%. In industrial sector, the share is employment share is 11% and GDP share is 22%. That means double. what do we observe?
Maybe many are the most of the people are working in agriculture, but their contribution is very less in GDP. Here in 2009 to 2010, from this 1970 to 73 table, what we observe, the agriculture was decreased. The people, those who are working in agriculture, was decreased. It means here 74, but whereas in 2009 to 2010 it reduced, it decreased to 53%. But if the GDP goes to 70% only, that means 1/3 only, that means 53% and 17, only 1/3 contribution. Okay, the industry 22% in employment, whereas in GDP it contributes 26%, but in service sector only 25% is there. But here it is 57%, that means double, more than double the share. By this, what do we observe? In agriculture, most of the people are working, but their GDP contribution is less. That means here we observe a typical type of employment. That means the people are working apparently, but as per their potential, they won't have their work there. That we call as a underemployment, or we call it as a disguised employment. That means, I will give you one example. We have a land, suppose you think that in our family there are 5 members. All the 5 members are working in same land. All are working. Sometimes among them only 3 members will work and the 2 they won't work. But if the 2 did not work also, the production which comes from that agriculture won't be as it is. That means they are treated as a part of underemployment. That means we observe, dominantly we observe disguised employment in agriculture. That should be, that means if they work in another sector, they can get more income. No? That type of disguised employment we observe in agriculture. Means the government has to provide employment opportunities to the people, those who are in the category of underemployment. The remaining topic we will discuss in the next class. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.